Hey guys, MMA one-on-one with Wolfman, with the world champion, Pedro Munhoz. Congratulations, sir.
Thank you so much.
That was an amazing five-round fight. You just retired the veteran, Jeff Curran. How's that feel?
I feel great after that fight. So Jeff Curran is a really tough opponent. I haven't been training so long and so hard for this fight. And I feel super happy right now to beat him.
Did you realize how good each round was going in your favor? That you were on fire, you were dominating the round on the feet, you were dominating the round by getting the takedowns and being on top. Did you know you were so in control? And anything he tried, you really showed you're a professional, kept your hands up high, he tried to trick you with some stuff, stuff like that.
I thought I dominated all those five rounds. I was all the time control the cage. I was moving forward all the time. I put him against the cage all those five rounds. I took him down all those five rounds. And he punched me, I punched him. He cut me with an elbow, but I put a lot of damage on his face as well. And, his jiu-jitsu was good, but I didn't see me in any situation was in danger position for me.
Yeah, I think you definitely were in charge the first round. You had the guts. You're such an exciting fighter. You went for the heel hook in the first round. I mean, most guys would not give up top position and go for a finish.
Yeah, I really liked your heel hook and guillotine. So that's why I had a couple finish fights with a heel hook. And then I tried to do the heel hook, but he defended very well. And he's a black belt in jiu-jitsu. He's really good. I felt, he's really tough opponent. He's really good on the ground as well.
There was one time, I think second round, and then a little bit in the fourth, he had an arm in guillotine. Not so tight, or just you were like, hey, I'm cool, and just work your way out?
It was tight, but I was the fan. I was, because the guillotine choke is, I really like the guillotine choke. And also, I can defend very well. And I put a lot of pressure on his stomach. I lifted up my butt, my hip. And that was the fan on his hand, but it was tight, but I was feel comfortable in the position.
Is tonight the first time you went past three rounds?
Tonight, yeah. So I fought for the title before, but I finished the final second round. So this time is my first fight for the belt that I fought five rounds. That's my first five rounds ever.
How did that feel on your body? I mean, did you feel in the fourth round, fifth round? How are you feeling?
I feel great. I was ready to fight more.
Yeah? You were doing great, man. I mean, it was really a masterclass performance. In MMA, a lot of guys just technically are so lacking, but you got Mr. Rafael Cordero yelling in their corner. Your hands are up high. Anything is throwing at you, your double forearm blocking. You were killing him with elbows. Really, he hadn't... He was trying tricky stuff, dropping his hands, throwing overhand rights, but nothing was really landing on him.
I thought he tried to do that because I think he was tired. I was put a lot of pressure in him. First, second, third round, he know he lost all the three rounds. And his opportunities would play around a little bit. And that's why I think he dropped his hand, tried to play a little bit.
What about the hook kicks? Like, he was throwing hook kicks to your head and weird stuff, side kicks to the body.
I didn't remember. I need to watch the fight again. Okay. I didn't remember exactly that moment. But I was super comfortable in any situation, any position, and he's a very tough opponent.
What the worst thing he really landed on you was some of the side kicks to the knee. I don't even know, but the commission seemed to have no problem with that. I thought California was one of the two states that linear kicks to the knee are illegal, but they seem to be fine with it, other than in the UFC. So did any of the kicks to the knee mess you up at all?
No, just one. He kicked me. I was too relaxed, and then I felt my legs go back a little bit. Okay. But all those, he threw like a four, five kicks like that, but I was with my level change, and when he kicked, so nothing bad.
And you talked about your stand-up looked crisp, looked great. Master Huff, Cordero, King's MMA is the best. You had Kenny Johnson in your corner. You took him down every round. So how did your takedown game feel?
Yeah, I haven't been improved a lot. My takedown, my wrestling skills, I have been training with Kenny Johnson and the Black House. We have a lot of wrestling guys really good there. And so my game I was think about it, to fight with him and take him down, because I saw his fights before, always he running to the cage, but he waited the opportunity to throw the knee. I knew that, so that's why I put it in hard hands first and then tried to take
him
down.
Yeah, I think second round was when you got the big one. I'm not sure which round, but you threw, I think, a straight right and then beautiful change of level, got the hands together behind. That's when you did the big lift and you dumped him, man. It was awesome.
Yeah, it was really good. I felt that moment in Matt Hills. Walked you.
Yeah, yeah.
and throw him.
Yeah, Matthew Sakurai. Yeah, I know what you're talking about. So anyway, great performance. You're 135-pound champ here in RFA. You could defend your title here, but I think UFC is going to be knocking. Joe Silva, Dana White, Sean Shelby, I'm calling you out. This guy's exciting, standing on the ground, even the wrestling, the jiu-jitsu. He's going for submissions, everything. I mean, you have to feel like you're an exciting fighter, and I think tonight, once you see the tape, you'll realize you're at that level now where you can hang with these UFC guys.
I'm ready to fight next step. I'm ready to fight. I'm ready to go to UFC. And for sure, I'm going to come back to the gym this week and going to train harder and harder to always try to get better. And I'm really excited, you know, fight with the best fighters in the world.
And you want to stay at 135?
Yeah, I think nothing about to go 125. I want to stay 135.
So, I mean, Hendon Burrell is the man there, you know, and Dominic Cruz may be coming back. So, what do you think about the footwork and boxing of Dominic Cruz or just, you know, kind of the Jose Aldo-like game of Hendon Burrell? He's got the hard low kicks and everything.
Yeah. Hendon Burrell, you know, he's really good. He has a really good boxing skills, and his jiu-jitsu is really good. Dominic Cruz, he footwork, he's so fast, but let's see. I hope, you know, I can fight with those fighters.
If you went in the UFC right now and you say got two wins under your belt, you think you could take out Hendon Burrell?
Yeah, why not?
It'd be a good fight, right?
Yeah, it's going to be a good fight.
It'd be a fan-friendly fight, right?
Yeah. It's
Congratulations, brother. I think you did a great job, my friend. And I look forward to seeing you fight in the future. Guys, this guy trains at Black House Kings MMA, so they can get a hold of you there, Ned Suarez, right?
Yeah. I train in the Black House. I train with Kenny Jones, dad. Also, I train in the Kings MMA with Rafael Cordero. And we have an excellent camp there. And you're going to try to get better and fight the best fighters in the world.
Well, guys, I'm Dan the Wolfman. Go to promomainnow.com for all your information. And please subscribe to my YouTube page. Thanks.